So yes, we were on page paragraph number 13, the bond of love. Then my son and I advised my wife and friends. Then my son and I advised my wife and friends advised her too to give Baba to the zoo at Mysore. He was getting too big to keep at home. After some weeks of such advice, she at last consented, agreed. Hastily and before she could change her mind, a letter was written to the curator of the zoo. Curator is the innkeeper or the in charge of the zoo, the one who takes care of the museum and all. Museum or zoo. So a letter was written to the curator of the zoo. Did he want a tame bear for his collection? He replied, yes, the zoo sent a cage from Mysore in a lorry, a distance of 87 miles, and Baba was packed off. So the wife, the narrator's wife, was advised by narrator and many of their friends that the bear should be sent to zoo. Because now it had become wild. It was becoming wilder day by day. So earlier the wife was not consenting, but finally she agreed. And before she would change her mind, the narrator wrote a letter to the curator of the zoo, asking if they needed a tame bear. And the answer was, of course, yes. And finally, a cage was sent in a lorry. Lorry is a sort of vehicle only. So a cage was sent, and that very cage came from a distance of about 87 miles, from very far off place. The point is, like, the cage came from very far off place, and finally the bear was sent. Now there is a question for all of you, and one child will be asked to answer it here. The question is, the narrator says that he hastily wrote a letter to the curator of the zoo. Why hastily? Why was the letter written hastily? Keshav will give the answer. Come here, Keshav. Come here and give the answer. Yes. Why was the letter written hastily? Yes, Jaskaran. Yes, very good. Silent clapping for Jaskaran. Because he thought that his wife's mind would change. His wife had agreed to send the beer after a long time. It was not very easy to convince her for this. But when the moment she agreed, that very minute, the narrator, you know, means in a hurried manner, he wrote a letter to the curator, thinking that maybe she would change her mind later on. Then he would not be able to send the bear to the zoo. We all missed him greatly, but in a sense, we were relieved. So though we missed him, of course, when the main member of a family goes, you always miss that person. We even become attached with the things also. And it was very much a living thing, living being. So they missed him, but somehow they were relieved also. Why were they relieved? Because he was always becoming a nuisance day by day. My wife was inconsolable. She could not be consoled. She was heartbroken. She wept and fretted. For the first few days, she would not eat a thing. Then she wrote a number of letters to the curator. How was Baba? Back came the replies. Well, but fretting, he refuses food too. So both sides the same condition. wife was inconsolable, and on the other side, the bear was also not very able to, was not able to adapt himself to the changes very immediately. So both of them were not eating food and all. The reason was like both of them missed each other. After that, friends visiting Mysore were begged to make a point of going to the zoo and seeing how Baba was getting along. So after that, friends visiting Mysore were begged to make a point of going to the zoo and seeing how Baba was going along. So afterwards, like, who was asked to visit the bear, last boy? Chaitanya. Yes. Who was asked to visit Baba, that is the bear? When I read the chapter, then you can look at the book as much as you want. But when I ask the question, then you have to look at me. Chaitanya, yes? Who was asked to visit the bear? Jayant? Who is speaking? Who was asked to visit him? Friends. Which friends? Okay. Yes, Chaitanya, sit down. So the friends who might be visiting Mysore, so they were asked to visit the zoo and see Baba to make sure whether he was all right or not. So they were supposed to see how Baba was getting along. They reported that he was well, but looked very thin and sad. All the keepers at the zoo said he was fretting. For 3 months, I managed to restrain my wife from visiting Mysore. What is restrain? To stop. So they informed the friends, reported that the bear had become very thin and weak. And moreover, it was looking very impatient. It looked worried. Worried is actually not a very appropriate word for this explanation. So the point is, like, he looked very out of the place at that place. Okay, he was not able to adjust or adapt himself to that place. So narrator did not let his wife visit the bear for 3 months, right? So he did not let her go there for 3 months. I'll ask you why. Why did narrator become so hard? I'll ask you this thing. For 3 months, I managed to stop my wife from visiting Mysore. Then she said one day, I must see Baba. Either you take me by car or I'll go myself by bus or train. So I took her by car. So for 3 months, the wife of narrator was, he could stop her, but then he could not. So he took her by car to that zoo. Now the question was, like, why didn't he want that she should go there and see that bear? Yes. Why did he stop her for 3 months? Okay. So that Baba could not recognize her after 3 months. Then what would happen if he could not recognize her? Okay, you are thinking at least. That's good change. Yes, Anshya? Okay, that is another issue. That is another reason. Because he knew that if his wife would go back, then she will not be able to bear the second separation. Okay, one separation was already difficult for her to bear, and second time she will not let him, she will not bear this separation. Okay, so in order to make sure that Baba doesn't come back home again, he was strict. He made sure that his wife did not go and see the bear again. And yes, he wanted that by the time, with the passage of time, that bear will forget his wife. Okay, so that was also there. Okay. Friends had, so she, So I took her by car. Friends had conjectured that the bear would not recognize her. I had thought so too. But while she was yet some yards from the cage, Baba saw her and recognized her. He howled with happiness. She ran up to him, patted him through the bars, and he stood on his head in delight. So though these people were all thinking like maybe that person, that bear, might have forgotten this lady, but it did not happen. So the moment, though she was a little distance away from the bear, he was able to recognize her and started howling in happiness. And when she reached near, he even stood on his head, just in happiness. For the next 3 hours, she would not leave that cage. She gave him tea, lemonade, cakes, ice cream, and whatnot. Then closing time came and we had to leave. My wife cried bitterly. Baba cried bitterly. Even the hardened curator and the keepers felt depressed. As for me, I had reconciled myself to what I knew was going to happen next. What is reconciling? What is to reconcile? Reconciliation is actually joining in together again, basically. Okay, reconcile, when you make amends for, okay, when you patch up for the loss. Okay, so here is, after for 3 hours, both narrator's wife and the bear were together. And during this 3 hours, the wife of narrator, she gave him whatever she could to eat or drink. And the narrator was mentally prepared, like after 3 hours, whatever would happen, he was mentally prepared for that. What he was mentally prepared for, that we will read yet, but we can make out. What will happen after 3 hours? Yes, so same thing. She will again become very emotional, including the bear will also become very emotional. So that emotional drama will be there. And narrator was very, very much mentally prepared for it. Oh, please, sir, she asked the curator, may I have my Baba back? Hesitantly, he answered, madam, he belongs to the zoo and is a government property now. I cannot give away government property, but if my boss, the superintendent at Bangalore, agrees, certainly you may have him back. So on what grounds did the curator refused to give him the bear? Yes, that it was a government property and the government property cannot be handed over to somebody like this. Okay, there followed the return journey to Bangalore and a visit to the superintendent's bungalow. So from there, this narrator and all, they went to Bangalore to visit the superintendent's house. A tearful pleading. So who might be doing this tearful pleading? Wife of narrator. Baba and I are both fretting for each other. Will you please give him back to me? He was a kind-hearted man and consented. Not only that, but he wrote to the curator telling him to lend us a cage for transporting the bear to Bangalore. So the superintendent agreed. Not only he agreed to give her the permission, he also agreed to give them a cage so that the bear is transported. But back we went to Mysore again, armed with the superintendent's letter. Baba was driven into a small cage and hoisted on top of the car. The cage was tied securely, and a slow and careful return journey to Bangalore was accomplished. So how did they come back? By car, right? So they came back by the same car. And they went, husband and wife went, but when they came back, then the bear was also with them. Bear was a cage kept on the top of the car in the cage. So how did they come back? They came in a very slow motion, okay? Once home, a squad of coolies were engaged for special work in our compound. So when they came home, then Cage had to be boarded down from the car. So the coolies were called in, and they started doing this job. An island was made for Baba. It was 20 feet long and 15 feet wide and was surrounded by a dry pit or moat, 6 feet wide and 7 feet deep. A wooden box that once housed fowls was brought and put on the island for Baba to sleep in at night. Straw was placed inside to keep him warm, and his baby, the gnarled stump, along with his gun, the piece of bamboo, both of which had been sentimentally preserved since he had been sent away to the zoo, were put back for him to play with. So when he was brought back, then what extra steps they had to take? Did they have to make some extra preparations to keep him there? Yes. What was the one word? What's the one word for that? They made one island. Okay, then island was all about a dry pit, yes, moat. And with him, the other things which he earlier also used to have, they were also placed with him. In a few days, the coolies hoisted the cage onto the island and Baba was released. He was delighted, standing on his hind legs. He pointed his gun and cradled his baby. My wife spent hours sitting on a chair there while he sat on her lap. He was 15 months old and pretty heavy too. So by this time, the bear, which had become about 15 months old, you can imagine like how huge it might have already become. Still, it would like to sleep on the narrator's wife's lap. Okay, the way my wife reaches the island and leaves it is interesting. I have tied a rope to the overhanging branch of a mango tree with a loop at its end. Putting one foot in the loop, she kicks off with the other to bridge the six-foot gap that constitutes the width of the surrounding pit. The return journey is made the same way. But who can say now that a sloth bear has no sense of affection, no memory, and no individual characteristics? So that huge bear, now it has been properly, it has been 100% tamed animal. Okay, that woman, that narrator's wife, she reaches up to him, and after having played with him, after having fed him or her, she comes out of it. And now no one can imagine that even a sloth bear has been tamed. So it's a bond of love. So what is the bond of love? What's the whole chapter about? Life, the love can transform even a wild animal into a civilized being. So can't education transform wild students into civilized students? Yes. Okay. So the chapter, did you like it? Did you like the chapter? So is it only about the animals that this bond of love exists? Or is it for human beings also? It is for human beings also? Both? Yeah. Okay, thinking about the text. Look at the text. Given in the box are some headings. Find the relevant paragraphs in the text to match the headings. An orphaned cub, Bruno's food chart, an accidental case of poisoning, playful Baba, pain of separation, joy of reunion. So these all, headings are there. You have to match these headings with the relevant paragraphs from the story. Do it. An orphaned cub. Which paragraph? Okay, third paragraph may have the title, An Orphaned Cub. See this, does it match or not? See. An Orphaned Cub. Does this title match the description of paragraph 3? Okay, then second point is Bruno's food chart. Okay, paragraph 6. So anyone who says it doesn't match, in the sixth paragraph, it's all about the food chart. You know? Okay, so like this, you do all these. Okay, done. Gurpal, where's the book? Your book. What's your name?
Ishan.
Why no book? Okay, last venture. Yes, Keshav. First, now answer the following questions. Stand up and speak the question and then answer. I got him for her by accident. I got him for her by accident. Yes. Krishna, yes. Who says this? Narrator says this. The narrator says this. Who do him and her refer to? Him refers to Bruno and her refers to his wife. Okay, third part. What is the incident referred to here? Are you Krishna? Speak when I ask you, okay? What is the incident referred to here? Keshav, I didn't ask you to better have a seat. Speak the answer, then you have, can do whatever. Yes, what's the incident referred to here? Yes, Panish, sit down. What is the incident referred to here? Why? Is it very difficult? The whole story of red? Incident Masoor? Masoor is an incident? Tell. It's not a matter of sorry. You're not committing a punishment. Wait. Last girl. That side. Yes, give the answer. What is the incident? We call it inferential skills. Infer. When you have read the whole story, when you are answering this kind of simple question, it's about infer, inference. What do you infer from what you've read? If you are not, this is the A level skill. Understanding level, and understanding in NEP 2020 is out of 10, it's the first level. If you're not able to infer this much of information, then very difficult. Instead of going in for tuitions here and there for whole of the day, give time to have focus. Give time to present work. Each thing is important, each and everything. It is called lack of skills, lack of understanding. It's a simple story which you might have read, heard, enjoyed. The narrator is saying that I got him for her by accident. You know that it is the narrator who is talking about Bruno, that Bruno, he brought Bruno for his wife. What's the incident then? Yes, beta. The incident is about how he brought Bruno home. You can describe it in a few words more. Yes, very good. What's your name? Nivedita. Very well done, Nivedita. Only this much, you know, skill you need to be up to date in studies. What you read, you should know what you have read. That's it. Sit down. You know, people complain about the things like they've not cracked and NEET or JEE, this or that, because they did not teach well, because that did happen. But the basic thing we don't know, like we should have some proper understanding. There are some children, those who never bother to do any work. You know, I agree. They are sleeping children. When you are sleeping, then it's okay. But when you are awake and you are not able to give the answer, then it's a little shocking. So find out the next questions also.